You have four shows on television right now. Four shows.
It wasn't like on purpose.
I know it wasn't on purpose, but you are in demand. Do you take a lot of naps? I mean, how do you avoid? When do you sleep? I do one show and I'm tired. You have four.
I don't get a lot of sleep. But I also have fun where I can. You know what I mean? I try and like recharge my batteries wherever I can. And my friends Bonnie Burton and Ann Wheaton introduced me to self-adhesive googly eyes. And they vandalize stuff. So every once in a while, just for fun, I will carry some googly eyes and just like stick them on stuff in public places, like gas tanks or doorknobs or whatever. Uh-huh. And it's just really kind of hilarious to see people see them, and then they just sort of smile about it. They're like, oh, there's eyes on this thing. Oh, it's like, it's almost like it's a face. That's very funny.
It cheers them up for a second.
I know. And it actually comes in handy if I want to sneak naps but still look busy. Check it.
That's fantastic. Can I try some? Do you have extras here?
Yeah, you can grab some.
Can I try some? Andy, here, you got to get on this.
I actually just grabbed a really satisfying nap.
This is good. Here, I got to try this because this is something I could use during interviews sometimes.
I know. You got to get your position just right, though, or else it's completely detectable.
Is this working? I like, Andy, if you get yours on, anyone tuning in right now is not going to understand what's going on. Well, people seem to prefer our show this way.
Yeah.
I think we're going to do it like this from now on.
See what I mean? That's totally
I'm
going
to put
free.
These on Eisenhower. Yeah.
But you got to get like...
Yeah, they're not
silly
sticking.
...about like get them on the mic and stuff.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. This is a good one too.
That was so childish and one of the more enjoyable things I've experienced in a while.
I got to be honest, I do a lot of really adult stuff.
Yeah. Woo! Fun. Didn't you bring? You've done this for a while. Didn't you bring? You brought toys. What you went on?
I brought that big toy. That first time that I came in.
Yeah, several times you've brought toys on my show. But you went on Johnny Carson's Tonight Show, and you brought a toy when you were a little kid.
I was a little kid. I was in one of the most awkward and embarrassing times of my life too. I was just going into junior high. Really wanted to fit in at school. I was just a woeful misfit. And I was like, oh, if I dress like them and I act like they get my hair cut, then maybe they will like me. And that totally failed. But there's a record of it on the Johnny Carson show, which is me really trying hard. But I brought ectoplasm from the real Ghostbusters toy line.
Yeah.
And
You brought slime ectoplasm on Johnny Carson's Tonight Show.
Even as a young kid, I was really into toy companies and like finding ways to connect with them. And I went to the toy fair that year and they gave me a bunch of this slime and I was like, oh man, I'm totally taking this on the Tonight Show. And so I did. I did, and Johnny dumped it out on his desk and then he threw it at Ed McMahon and Ed McMahon threw it at him and I was like, chaos on television!
Let's take a look. I think we have a picture of that. That just breaks, oh my God. Yeah. Look at you.
Yeah.
That's fantastic. Is that from...
That's my IOU t-shirt and my Coca-Cola sweatpants.
A look that never went out of style.
It doesn't go out of fashion, guys. I've been a fashion maverick since I was a child, you see.
Yes. Dad's... I gotta mention this. Dad's airs Tuesday nights at 8 on Fox. You having fun with it? You having a good time?
Oh my gosh, it's so much fun. And it's in front of a live audience, which is like doing a play every week. But you do it in 4 days. We get the script and then you rehearse it all week and then you put it up in front of the audience and they tell you whether or not it's funny in a hurry. And a lot of times the writers will rush in and they'll be like, change this line, do this line. And then we try that and the audience laughs and whichever one is better, they use it. So it's kind of like a thrill ride, except there's no consequences. You know what I mean? Because you perform in front of the audience and if you mess up, they kind of like that. They almost appreciate seeing
that you're a human being, too. They see...
Well, versus watching it on TV, they're actually experiencing it, you know, in front of them. So that's been a really fun experience, too.
Someday we're going to get a live audience in here. Instead of this recording we're using tonight.